Good afternoon everyone, myself Piyusha S.Shetgar. Today we will see the topic microwave component, magic tea. These are the learning outcomes. At the end of this session, students will be able to derive the scattering matrix for magic tea junction. They will be able to apply the properties of S matrix to magic tea junction. These are the contents. So what is microwave T junction? Microwave T junction is an interconnection of three waveguides in the form of English alphabet T. So there are the several types of the T junctions. These are the microwave components. H plane T junction, E plane T junction, and the combination of E plane T and H plane T junction, that is, it is also called as magic T junction. So before going to start the microwave component magic T junction, you can pause video here for a second and recall that what are the properties of S matrix. Now what is magic T junction? Magic T junction, it is also called as EH plane T junction. It is formed by attaching two simple waveguides, one parallel and the other is in series, to a rectangular waveguide which already have the two ports. This is called as a magic T junction. It is also known as hybrid or 3 dB coupler. The arms of rectangular waveguide makes the two ports are called collinear ports. That is, if the rectangular waveguide having the already two ports, port 1 and port 2, are collinear, while port 3 is called as a H arm, or it is connected in parallel, therefore it is also called as a parallel port. Port 4 is connected in series, so it is called as a E arm or difference port or series port. So this is the magic T junction. So here the rectangular waveguide which having the ports 1 and port 2 already are collinear with each other. If the H arm is connected here at the side arm of the rectangular waveguide and E arm is connected here, so you can say that it is the combination of E and H plane T, therefore it is known as a magic T junction. In practical session, you can use this magic T junction which having the ports 1 and port 2, and the port 3 and port 4 are nothing but the E arm and H arm. So what are the characteristics of the magic T? So if the signal is applied to port 1 and port 2, which having the equal phase and the magnitude, then the output at port 4 is equal to 0, whereas output at port 3 is nothing but the addition of the input at port 1 and port 2. It is known as the additive property of the magic T. So if the signal is fed at the port 3, then the power is divided between the port 1 and port 2 equally, while the output at port 4 is equal to 0. That is, if the input is applied to port 3, the output at port 4 is equal to 0. It is denoted with S43 equal to 0. S43 is one of the scattering coefficient of the magic T junction. So if the signal is fed at one of the collinear port, that is at port 1 or port 2, then there appears no output at the another collinear port, as the E arm produces a phase delay and the H arm produces a phase advanced. Therefore, S12 equal to S21 equal to 0. Now let us discuss the properties of the magic T. So as you know that the port 1 and port 2 are collinear port, but if you are applying the input to port 1, you are not getting the output at the another collinear arm. This is the important property of the magic T. It is somewhat like a magic, and therefore it is known as the magic T junction. So it having the four ports, port 1, 2, 3 and 4. Therefore the S matrix for the magic T is defined by 4 by 4 order. Thus it having the four possible inputs and the four possible outputs. Now how to calculate the S matrix for the magic T? Let us calculate the each parameter defined by this S matrix. Since it is a 4-port junction, the scattering matrix is of order 4 by 4. So it having the scattering coefficients, or it is also known as, as a scattering parameters. So total 16 parameters are there, S11 to S44. The properties of the magic T can be defined by this matrix. So let us applying the properties of the S matrix to define the S matrix for the magic T junction. Now, because of the plane of the symmetry in H plane T junction, S23 equal to S13. That is, if the input is applied to port 3, you are getting the same output at port 1 and port 2. So, meaning of this is nothing but the plane of symmetry. Therefore, the S23 becomes equal to S13. Now, port 1 and port 2 are out of phase for the E plane T junction, and therefore S24 is equal to minus S14. That is, if the input is applied to E arm, you are getting the output at port 2 and port 1 are same but out of phase, and therefore it can be written as S24 equal to minus of S14. Now, because of the geometry of the junction at port 3 and port 4, S34 equal to S43 equal to 0. That means if the input is applied to port 4, you are getting the output at port 3 equal to 0. And if the input is applied to port 3, output at port 4 is equal to 0. Now consider the next property as a symmetry property. Here, symmetry property is nothing but Sij equal to Sji. That is, the number of column for this matrix is equal to the number of column for the second matrix. So by using this property, you can write these coefficients are equal. That is, S12 equal to S21, 13 equal to 31, 23 equal to 32. And from the figure equation number 1, S23 is nothing but S13. Therefore, S23 equal to S32 equal to S13. Similarly, S34 equal to S43, S24 equal to 42, S41 equal to S14, which is nothing but equal to minus S24 from equation number 2. Now, the next property, as the port 3 and port 4 are perfectly matched to the junction, S33 equal to S44 equal to 0. That is, if the input is applied to the port 3, the same port which having the output is equal to 0. Now, using all these values for the scattering coefficients, you can rewrite the matrix defined in above slide. So, you are getting the matrix for this magic T is nothing but this one. While in this case, the lower rectangular box becomes is equal to 0. Thus, you can observe this matrix which having the 4 unknown value which you have to define the values for this S parameters. Now, from the unitary property is nothing but the scattering matrix multiplied with the complex conjugate of that scattering matrix, it becomes equal to the unitary matrix. So, here the scattering matrix is considered, each parameter is complex conjugated which becomes equal to the unitary matrix. Now, by solving this equations, taking the combination of the row 1 and the column 1 for the second matrix, R1, C1, R2, C2, R3, C3 and R4, C4. You can write the equation 6, 7, 8, 9 for this. Now, from the equation 8 and 9, you are getting the equation twice of S13 square is equal to 1. Here, by solving this equation, getting the equation for the scattering coefficient S13 is equal to 1 by root 2. Similarly, S14 is equal to 1 by root 2. Now, from equation 6 and 7, you know the equation 6 and 7, these two are the equations. So, by comparing these equations, all parameters are equal except this S11 and S122. Therefore, you can write S11 and S22 from equation 6 and 7. Putting these values from equation 10 into the equation number 6, you are getting this equation. Now, from this equation, you can write S11 square plus S12 square is equal to 0. So, by solving this equation, both parameters S11 and S12 becomes equal to 0. From this equation, you know that S11 to equal to S22, and therefore, in above slide, you are getting the value of S11 as equal to 0, and therefore, S22 is also equal to 0. Now, you know all these four parameters. You can put all these parameters into the S matrix. So, this is the S matrix for the magic T, which having the values is 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2 and minus 1 by root 2 because of the E plane T junction. Now you know that how to find out the output for these all ports. So this is the equation, output matrix B equal to S into A, while this output matrix is the B and the input matrix is defined with this column matrix as a A, and this is the scattering matrix. So by using this you can write the equation for the four outputs B1, B2, B3 and B4. Thus you are getting this equation 15, 16, 17 and 18. Now consider the different cases. The case 1, input is applied to port 3, that is no input is at port 1 and 2 and 4. Thus by putting all these values in the above equation, getting B1 equal to and B2 equal to 1 by root 2 A3. This is the property of H-plane T-junction which I have discussed in the previous slides. Now the case 2, consider that now the input is applied to port 4 and the other ports are equal to 0. Put all these values in the above equation, thus you are getting B1 and B2 having the same values, but these are out of phase to each other, and this is the property of E-plane T-junction. While the output at port 3 and port 4 is equal to 0. Consider the case 3, if the input is applied to port 1 and the other inputs are at port other ports equal to 0. Now by putting all these values, you are getting B3 equal to B4, the same values 1 by root 2 of A1. That is, when the power fed to port 1, there is no any output at port 2, even though they are collinear ports. Thus, it like a magic, and therefore, these are called as isolated ports. Similarly, if the input is applied to port 3, you are not getting any output at port 4. Thus, E and H ports are also isolated ports. These are the references for this session. Thank you.